Hello students, I am Dr. Kavita, Assistant Professor, Maharani Science College for Women, Mysore. In this video, let us take a topic, second order reaction in chemical kinetics. So during this, we will come to know how to obtain an integrated rate expression for second order reaction when A is not equal to B and when A is equal to B and at the end half lifetime of a reaction. In second order reaction, let us take first case, that is when the two reactants are different when A is not equal to B. Consider a general reaction in which reactant A reacts with reactant B to give product B. Let A mole per dm cube be the initial concentration of reactant A and B mole per dm cube be the initial concentration of reactant B. After time t, if x mole per dm cube of the product is formed, the remaining concentration of reactant A will be A minus x and that of B will be B minus x. Since we know the rate of the reaction depends on concentration of the reaction, the differential rate equation for this reaction can be written as dx by dt, that is change in concentration with time, directly proportional to product of concentration of reactants A and B, or dx by dt equals k into concentration of reactant A into concentration of reactant B, where k is proportionality constant known as rate constant or velocity constant. In this expression, for the concentration of reactant A, we can write A minus X and for the concentration of B as B minus X. So dx by dt will be equal to K into A minus X into B minus X. Now we can separate the variables. That is A minus X into B minus X can be brought to this side and dt to this side by cross multiplication. So on separating the variables, it will be dx upon A minus X into B minus X equals K into dt. So here now we have to integrate the equation. So here in the denominator, it is the product of A minus X into B minus X. So first we have to resolve into partial fraction. So on resolving into partial fraction, assuming A is greater than B. Then on resolving into partial fraction, it will be equal to 1 upon A minus B into 1 upon B minus X minus 1 upon A minus X. Now we can substitute for this expression, this whole term. Now, on integration, that is 1 upon A minus B is constant. So, remaining term we can integrate with respect to dx and k with respect to dt. Since we know the integration of 1 upon A minus X with respect to dx equals minus log of A minus X, we can use this in this expression. So it will be 1 upon A minus B into integration of 1 upon B minus X is minus log B minus X minus integration of 1 upon A minus X is minus log A minus X equals K is constant. So integration of 1 with respect to dt is t plus c, that is some integration constant. Here this equation minus into minus becomes plus, and now here we can use the form log a minus log b will be equal to log a upon b. Here also in this equation log a minus x minus log b minus x can be written as log a minus x upon b minus x. So the equation will be 1 upon a minus b log a minus x upon b minus x equals k into t plus c. Let this be the equation 1. Now we can find the value of integration constant c, taking when t is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. That is when before starting the reaction, t will be equal to 0 and x will be also equal to 0. Now this term k into t will becomes 0 and x will be 0. Then c will be equal to 1 upon a minus b into log a by b. Now we can substitute for the value of c in equation 1. On substituting, you will get this equation. And in this equation, we can bring this whole term to left hand side. Now, in both the terms, 1 upon a minus b is constant. We can take it outside the bracket. So, it will be 1 upon a minus b log of a minus x upon b minus x minus log a by b equals k into t. Now again it is in the same form, log a minus log b. So it will be log a upon b equals, on simplification you will get this term. So we can substitute this for this whole term. So it will be this in this form. So now you can bring t to this side, and converting natural log to log base 10 by multiplying it in 2.303, you will get this expression. So where k is equal to 2.303 upon t into a minus b log b into a minus x upon a into b minus x. This is the expression, that is the integrated expression for rate constant for second order reaction when a is not equal to b. Suppose if you assume b is greater than a, then on integration we will end up with the expression k equals 2.303 upon t into b minus a into log of a into b minus x upon b into a minus x. Now let us see what will be the unit for rate constant in second order reaction. So here, unit for concentration terms in the numerator and in the denominator gets cancelled. Remaining is 1 upon time, that is expressed in seconds for concentration, mole per dm cube. So it will be dm cube per mole per second. Now let us take the second case, that is when both the reactants are same, that is the condition is when A is equal to B. In this, two molecules of the same reactants are involved in the reaction. So let us consider A plus A giving product or 2A giving product. Let A be the initial concentration of reactant A, that is A mole per dm cube. And after time t, if x amount of product is formed, then the remaining concentration of reactant A will be A minus x. Now the differential rate expression will be dx upon dt proportional to concentration of reactant A raised to power 2, or dx upon dt equals k into concentration of reactant A raised to power 2. So here instead of concentration of A at time t, we can substitute for A minus x, where k is velocity constant. Now dx upon dt will be equal to k into a minus x whole square. Again here we can separate the variables, that is you can bring a minus x whole square to this side. Now on integration, this equation we will get integration of 1 upon a minus x square will be equal to 1 upon a minus x equals k is constant, integration of 1 with respect to dt is t plus c, there is some integration constant. Let this be equation 1. Now we can find the value of integration constant c, taking when t is equal to 0, x will be equal to 0. Substituting this in equation 1, this term is will become 0, x is 0. So remaining c is equal to 1 upon a. Now, putting the value of c, that is 1 upon a, in equation 1, we will get 1 upon a minus x equals k into t plus 1 upon a. Now we can bring 1 upon a to left hand side. So you will get kt equals 1 upon a minus x minus 1 upon a. Now we can take the LCM. So a into a minus x. On simplification, you will get a minus of a minus x. Removing the bracket, it will be a minus a minus into minus plus x upon a into a minus x. Plus a minus a gets cancelled. Kt equals x upon a into a minus x. Or k will be equal to 1 upon t into x upon a into a minus x. This is the expression for rate constant for second order reaction when a is equal to b. Now let us see about half lifetime of a reaction expressed in terms of t half. The half life of a reaction is the time required for the reaction to be half completed, or it can be defined as the time in which the concentration of a reactant is reduced to one half of its initial concentration. Let us take the expression for rate constant k when a is equal to b. So in this equation, we can take the time as t half, that is half life time. Then at half life time, x will be equal to a by 2. Substituting this in the above expression, you will get x equals a by 2. Here also x is equal to a by 2. A minus a by 2 becomes a by 2. So a by 2 in the numerator and in denominator gets cancelled. So k will be equal to 1 upon t half into 1 upon a. Or t half will be equal to 1 upon k into a. Or t half is proportional to 1 upon a. That is, half life time of a second order reaction is inversely proportional to the initial concentration of the reactant. So with this, I will end this topic. Thank you. Thank you, student.